Next, we will briefly discuss some issues in the assessment of dementia among Japanese American families. The research on Nikkei and dementia is extremely sparse. Most of what we know is based on the findings of two major longitudinal studies. The first is the HAAS, or the Honolulu Asian Aging Study, of approximately 3,700 Japanese American men. It began in 1965 to study risk factors for cardiovascular diseases and was then expanded to include neurodegenerative diseases in men born between 1900 and 1919, and there is now some data on women available. The KAME project was based in Seattle, Washington, and started in 1992 and ended in 2001. KAME means turtle, and that population was about almost 2,000 men and women of Japanese descent. And it was originally a cross-cultural study of Alzheimer's disease and prevalence incidence rates and vascular dementia among Japanese in Japan, Hawaii, and Seattle. And the latest data included caregiving issues. Sadly, some places where data could have been collected have been closed. The Stanford VA Alzheimer's Disease Center closed in 2009 due to a lack of state funds, and the NIA-funded Alzheimer's Center closed in 2006. So again, there is relatively little research available. Prevalence rates for dementia, as discussed by Dr. Yeo, reported rates similar to whites in both the Honolulu study and the KAME study. Other smaller studies, mostly in Hawaii, have examined perceptions of dementia among Nikkei. For example, dementia was perceived as normal aging, but abnormal behaviors could be attributed to being crazy or insane. And people who exhibited some of these were labeled as kichigai, which means crazy or insane. In Hawaii, it was discovered that dementia in males was more difficult to diagnose. Japanese American males were able to hide their cognitive deficits longer than females because women had more tasks and roles that required higher functioning cognitive abilities, which made detection much easier. Due to shikataganai and gaman, Nikkei women tend to accept and adapt to caregiver stressors more than their mainstream caregiver counterparts. But it was found that they still need and can benefit from caregiver resources and assistance. Others have shown there is a reluctance to report symptoms of dementia by elders and their families out of fear that these symptoms are a result of genetic defects, of punishment or karma, or poor family care and attention. Thus, dementia and Alzheimer's disease are considered a silent epidemic among Japanese Americans due to failure to recognize and report early cognitive and behavioral changes. And they found that many times the families waited for crisis before they would seek help. Language issues also play a large role in the assessment of dementias among Nikkei elders. There is a need for culturally relevant assessment instruments for use in the Japanese-speaking community. That's most important for monolingual, non-English speaking elders, such as Kibe or the war brides or newcomers. But it is not enough to simply translate words from the original English versions. Instruments must also be culturally relevant and appropriate. And there is also one other consideration that is very important. We must also consider the health literacy levels of the instruments and the information. And that is that the levels of understanding among the patients should be assessed, and the presentation of information by healthcare providers. For your information, the COMET project translated all the instruments listed on this slide. I won't read them all, but there is information available. And the investigators reported that satisfactory equivalence was achieved between the English and the Japanese.